Hey guys, what's up? My name is Speedbreaker, and in today's video, we're gonna have a look at the in-game performance when live streaming using OBS Studio compared to using Streamlabs OBS or SLOBS, and comparing that to the newly released OBS Live. Now, first, let's have a look at these three OBS derivatives. OBS Studio is basically the original OBS, so not really much to talk about there. Then we have Streamlabs OBS, which is the OBS fork by Streamlabs. And then finally, we have OBS Live, which is basically a plugin to regular OBS Studio developed by Streamelements. Now, many large names in the streaming industry have actually changed over to Streamelements. And with that, I was obviously curious to see what their new software, or rather plugin, for OBS Studio might bring to the table. Now, before jumping right into the results, let's have a look at my streaming rig. I'm using an i7-7700K processor clocked at 5 GHz, 32 GB of DDR4 memory clocked at 2400 MHz, the RTX 2080 Founders Edition, and all games are saved on an NVMe SSD. Now, the two settings that I'm going to be streaming at is X264 at 6000 kilobits per second at the very fast preset and the high profile, as well as NVENC also at 6000 kilobits per second and at the high quality preset and the high profile. I'll be playing in 1440p and downscaling the games to 960p using the Lanczos filter. The reason why I'm using Lanczos is because it basically provides the highest possible in-game performance compared to any other method of downscaling. If you're interested in a very in-depth comparison of the different filters and different downscaling methods, then check out the video in the card right now. Now, the games I'm going to be running benchmarks for are Fortnite, Counter-Strike Global Offensive, as well as PUBG. All of the games are going to be played, or replayed rather, using the internal replay system to actually provide a fair benchmark, and the games are all set to ultra settings. So, beginning with Fortnite, and first I'd like to show the raw performance difference between the different OBS derivatives by simply having a game capture enabled. So I only had one scene and one source, which is the game capture, and then I streamed a Fortnite replay to get a baseline performance of the different OBS versions. Shown in blue are frames per second and in orange frame time. So this is basically the time that it took my computer to produce the next frame. On the bottom we have the base, so without streaming at all. Then come three blocks with NVENC and three blocks X264 streaming. Now, Fortnite is a very GPU intensive game, and therefore using NVENC over X264 doesn't really yield much higher performances as it would be observed with other games that are much more CPU intense. Next, let's have a look what happens when we enable overlays. So in terms of OBS Studio, what I did was I actually have to have different sources to get together my entire overlay. So I have to add text sources for the latest follower, I have to add media sources for the image overlays, and then of course the video capture device for the camera. In OBS Live, I can have all of the overlays in one browser source, which I then host on Streamelements. And finally for SLOBS, once again I need multiple different sources to get the final in-game overlay. Now I'm only showing results for NVENC because I only have a limited amount of time to do these testings, and in blue you can see the old values without having any overlays, and in orange the new ones with the overlays enabled. Once again, you can see that the differences are almost negligible, and except for maybe OBS Studio with all of the different overlays being the lowest performing in-game, there isn't really a clear winner between OBS Live and Streamlabs OBS. For the record, I repeated the same benchmark using the medium graphic settings, and as you can see on screen, there is once again no difference between using Streamlabs OBS or OBS Live. Next, let's have a look at CSGO, and this is once again without any overlays enabled. And because CSGO is a very CPU intensive game, we can see a clear performance decrease by going from NVENC to X264. Also, we can see that Streamlabs OBS is about the worst performing of the three, whereas OBS Live and regular OBS perform about the same. Now, moving on to the overlay performance benchmarks, we can see that OBS Live produces the highest performance out of the three OBS derivatives. Therefore, if you're live streaming CSGO, I would highly recommend OBS Live for the highest in-game performance. Finally, moving on to PUBG, which is once again a much more GPU intensive game than CSGO, however not as GPU intensive as Fortnite, and we can see once again a clear difference between streaming using X264 and NVENC. Moreover, it appears that OBS Live produces the highest in-game performance over the other two options. Finally, when having a look at the results when having overlays enabled, we can see that OBS Live once again comes out as the clear winner. In fact, OBS Live with overlay is even better than having Streamlabs OBS without any overlays. So the difference is actually quite noticeable between OBS Live and Streamlabs OBS. So basically, if you're playing PUBG and are using SLOBS, then maybe switching over to OBS Live might make your life a little bit better. Alright, so these are the results that I'm getting on my machine. Keep in mind that your result might greatly vary from what I'm shown in this video. This all depends on the hardware that you have in your computer, what kind of resolution you're playing at, what kind of resolution you're streaming at, if you're streaming at 60 or 30 FPS, and most importantly, what kind of game you're playing. But if you're interested in OBS Live, then you can find a download link in the description below. I will soon be doing a full video tutorial series on how to do your own custom overlay using Streamelements. But as always, if you still have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. If you like this kind of content, leave me a like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you very much for watching, have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys in the next video.